Okay guys, welcome back. It's Ekemini Robert from electronicsdiary.com. Okay, here is my blog website properly connected to a custom domain, okay? But the thing is, when I try to visit the blog subdomain URL, all right, instead of getting here directly, I get this redirection page. This could happen for a few reasons: improper DNS setup, or sometimes connection to Cloudflare. When you connect to your blog or website to Cloudflare, you could get this error message. Some people take care of it by gray clouding these two CNAME records. This will take care of the redirection error issue. Alright. It will take care of the redirection error issue. But the thing is, you will lose out on the services you get from Cloudflare. That is not always the last option. So today I'll share how to remove that redirection page without gray clouding those status icons. Alright, it's quite simple, so let's begin. Okay, so what you do is you need to create to give it whatever name you'd like. Okay, just like that, or something a little bit more reasonable. Okay. Alright, that's it. You create your blog. Create a new blogger website. And once you do that, what you need to do is you have to bring this name to the new blogger page you have created. The idea is that once you do that, when you bring the name down here, you set up a redirect here. So a redirection command at another place, but with the name. All right, let's proceed so we don't get ourselves confused. All right, so open Blogger in another tab. Once you open Blogger in another tab, what you do is go to settings. Nice, quick and easy. Once you get to settings, we need to bring this name to the new Blogger website we have just created. Okay, so in order to do that, we have to remove these settings for a few seconds, because there is no way to change this name without removing custom domain. Okay, are you sure this will remove? All right, I'm pretty damn sure. Okay, all right, so what you do is you edit this name, copy that. Once you copy that, you want to change this name to whatever other name you know does not exist. All right, so immediately after that, I click on that, and receive settings, and you are back. So what you do is you bring that name to this new blogger site we have created. rename this. Okay, so now your blog or website is now here. All right, we did the separation and the blogger's subdomain is now here, while the name it was previously connected to is now here. But we have successfully given it a different subdomain. This we did by creating a new blog and then renaming it. So what you do next is you set up a JavaScript redirection command. So let's get the JavaScript and then put it in the head of the HTML. You copy this. All right, if you are on the website, what you do is just check below this video and you will find this JavaScript redirection command. And if you're watching this on YouTube, just check the description, scroll down, and you will find this code. Then you copy it to the head of the HTML of the new website. Place it anywhere within the head, but do not forget to change this to the custom domain you are setting up the redirection for. All right, this is it, right? This is where you want your site to be. And that is that. Save theme. All right, once theme is saved, so let's try to visit this. All right, once it gets here, it's going to be redirected by the JavaScript down here. It's that easy. So beautiful, without gray clouding your Cloudflare icons. And I know people could worry about things like feed burner. Your feed burner here stays the same and nothing changes. Your blog ID remains the same. So if you are using Blogger API, you don't have any problems. Since these things work with blog ID, they remain the same. And how about your CNAME records? CNAME records remain the same. Okay, so if you go to Cloudflare CNAME records, they remain the same. Nothing changes. We're done there, but just before you go, make sure this website can be indexed. Okay, save that. Google and other search engines should be able to visit the blog and actually see that it's here and it's going there. Once you're done setting up that, you need to take care of your robot.txt. So copy your robot.txt from here, settings, search preference. All right, make sure you copy your robot.txt. You need them, it's on the website. Just scroll down, you find them somewhere below this video on the website. Copy your robot.txt, go to settings. Okay, yes. And paste this here. be sure to make the necessary changes. Okay, this is for the subdomain we have created. Alright, I have that code there because I do not want search engines to crawl archived pages on Blogger. Alright. Okay, so robot.txt for my fans.ga, and this is the robot.txt for my fans.blogspot.com. All right. Okay, save changes, and that is about all you need to do. Apart from that, the other reason why you could get this redirection error that says this blog is not hosted on Blogger and has not been checked for spam, viruses, and other forms of malware. Do you wish to be redirected? Some people set up a subdomain, for example, tv.formyfans.com, but fail to include that in the DNS. So you set up a CNAME record, include TV and map it to gss.google.com. That is it. If you need to see your redirection pathway, what you need to do is just install a redirection pathway add-on to your browser. Just enter the URL of the website you wish to visit. Say the one we just finished setting up, and click on the plugin icon, and it will right away show you the redirection pathway of the website. Okay, this is the URL we entered, but it followed a JavaScript redirection command that and then brought us here. So this gives you how it happened and also shows you the status code for the website. Have any comments? Put them below or visit the website and drop them in the article. Like this video and share with friends that are using Blogger or having similar issues. So visit electronicsdiary.com for more of this and many more helpful articles. Thank you for watching.